Hello, welcome to you all. Welcome to Bunch and Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today I am going to discuss about the basics of dynamics of fluid. So first question arises that what do you mean by dynamics of fluid? In dynamics of fluid, we basically study a fluid motion with force causing flow. I repeat again, study of fluid motion with force causing flow. Fluid motion with forces, study of fluid motion with forces which causing a flow. So here we know that with respect to Newton's second law of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So suppose assuming fluid is moving or flow is occurring in a horizontal axis, which is assuming here I mean as a x-axis. So force in x-axis will be equal to mass into acceleration in x coordinate or x-axis. So the force can be or flow can be occurred in a fluid with respect to this five force element. Here first force is due to gravity. Fg is known as force due to gravity. Fp is a force due to pressure. Fv is a force due to viscous force. Fv is the viscous force. Ft is the force due to fluid turbulence. And Fc is the force due to compressibility of a fluid. If we adding all these five elements into the x-axis due to because I am here assuming that flow is occurring in the x-axis, so x component will come out as a fgx plus fpx plus fvx plus ftx plus fcx is equal to fx. Total resultant will be fx, which is equal to mass into acceleration with respect to Newton's second law of motion. So we know that f is equal to m into a due to Newton's second law of motion. So this will be the resultant equation motion for fluid moving in x axis or in a horizontal axis. So taking this equation further, suppose considering first condition that if the fluid is incompressible, as we know that fluid will be incompressible from condition. So if the fluid is incompressible, then compressibility force or the force due to compressibility will equal to zero in this equation. So the resultant equation will be fx is equal to gravitational force component into x with respect to x axis, pressure force due to x axis, viscous force component x axis, and turbulence flow x axis. This equation will come out, and this equation will be known as Reynolds equation. This equation is also known as a Reynolds equation, this resultant equation, when the fluid is incompressible in a dynamic condition. Moving on further, taking this equation further, after compressibility condition, after incompressible condition, if we taking the fluid is not turbulent, it is laminar. If it is laminar, not turbulent, suppose fluid is not laminar, then it is turbulent. Or if it is turbulent, if it is not turbulent, then it is laminar. So here I am assuming because the dynamic resultant equation will be in the dynamic fluid flow condition, the Ft component is coming here. So if the turbulent flow is zero and then the flow is laminar type flow, so the resultant equation will be fx is equal to fgx component plus fpx component plus fvx component, gravitational force plus pressure force plus viscous force, component with respect to x axis, this resultant equation will be known as Navier-Stokes equation. Fx is equal to fgx plus fpx plus fvx is also known as Navier-Stokes equation. Further, taking this equation, when considering the fluid is viscous, non-viscous type, or if the viscous force is zero, then viscous effect is zero. If suppose viscous effect is zero, non-viscous type of fluid is taking place, then the resultant equation will be Fx is equal to gravitational force component plus pressure force component, and this resultant equation is also known as Euler equation of motion. So these are the three basic types of motion for fluid when we considering this dynamics fluid of motion equation for deriving this equation with respect to pressure force, gravity force, viscous force, turbulent force or compressible force, compressibility force. So this is the basics of dynamics of fluid which you need to derive further the Reynolds equation, Navier-Stokes equation or Euler equation. I hope you like this video. If you have any query regarding this video, then please tell me in below the video comment section box. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Kindly press the bell icon adjacent to subscription button to get further notification related to my channel. Thank you.